Hi, my name is Eric the Trainer. I'm a Hollywood physique expert from Los Angeles, California. I've come here to India to specifically work with the Gold's Gym India trainers to make them better, to make them enthusiastic, and to help them become the very best in the world. You know, the Gold's Gym is already the marquee brand of all gyms in the world, and I've traveled the globe many times. I've been throughout America, I've been to Canada, I've been to Europe, I've been to the Middle East, and now for the first time I've come here to India to meet my new friends. This guy's fantastic, and so are all the other Gold's Gym trainers. So it's my mission, it's my aim to give my 25 years of knowledge of being a personal trainer to the Gold's Gym trainers here in India, and it's been a great experience. Thank you so much for having me come. Thank you, and thank you.
Eric is the best celebrity fitness trainer, and we wanted him to share some of his secrets, how he transformed the Hollywood celebrities in the quickest time. So we have brought him here to share his secrets and give it to our trainers so that we can transform people in shorter period of time.
The way that I got into fitness is actually a really great story, because I grew up in a very rural environment on a farm. When I say farm, I mean with animals. We had sheep, we had pigs, we even had a donkey. So I grew up in this very rural area where physical beauty was not focused upon. I grew up in a way where people didn't necessarily dress up for work, dress up for school. There was no emphasis put on physical beauty. And when I was younger, I was very, very short. So short that all the women that I loved looked like they could be my babysitter. They looked like we were not the same age. In my class of 300 children, I was the shortest for years and years, and I didn't like it. I wanted to be strong, like the guys I saw in comic books. I wanted to be like Batman and Superman. I wanted to be very strong, but I was very little. Eventually, when I got a little bit older, I grew taller. So I went to the gym to try to fill out my lanky physique. I wanted to build some muscle. When I got there, I was very thin, but something interesting happened. Something magical. If I ate protein and healthy food, if I worked out the right way, my body started to shift and change. It was incredible. The more that I worked out at the gym, the more the girls that I liked looked at me. I loved that. I was so happy. I couldn't believe that I had found a place, the gym, where someone very small and weak could work and emerge as a different person, as a hero. And so I fell in love with the gym. At that time, at a young age, I decided I want to dedicate my life to helping other people go through a transformation from normal to extraordinary. And I've never looked back. I've been doing this for 25 years. For those of you here in India that are worried that you'll start going to the gym with enthusiasm, but then your life gets very, very busy, and so you wouldn't come to the gym very often, maybe you'll put on weight, you should not worry, and I'll tell you why. The purpose of a personal trainer, whether it's this gentleman or me, our job is to be the lifeguard of your good looks and good health. So we can almost break your fitness world into two parts. Step one is we meet each other, you meet a personal trainer, and we decide based on your goals what you want to achieve, and we transform you into this new person. But that's only step one. Step two, which is equally important, is we keep you in great shape forever. Only a few times a week do you have to see us, but our skills are so good, and our goals for you, our aim is so high, that we will maintain a beautiful fitness level and help you with your good looks and good health all the time. Remember, it's much easier to stay in good shape than it is to get into good shape. So it's really two parts. Step one, we get you into good shape, and we do it fast and with a smile on our face. Step two, only here at Gold's, we maintain that great shape so you can live your busy life looking and feeling your very best. Make us responsible for your good looks, and you'll be very happy.
It is very important to have a right attire while gymming. Number one, you should be feeling confident when you work out. You should be comfortable with whatever exercises you do. So it has, I prefer mostly loose fitting clothes, dry fit clothes that suck your sweat and gives you a better feeling while workout. It should be a proper loose track pants and a gymming shoes that gives you a better base of support. If you're doing any kind of running or jumping activities or lifting heavy weights, the base has to be strong. So it should be a proper gymming wear shoes and loose comfortable clothes.
When it comes to wearing the right attire at the gym, I agree with my friend here. It should be comfortable, it should be functional, it should help you attain your fitness goals with ease. But to tell you the truth, as a trainer, I don't care what kind of clothes you wear to the gym. I have some very famous actors, very, very famous, that wear an old t-shirt to the gym. I have some normal clients who work in offices who wear very expensive gym clothes and they're very fashionable. But at the end of the day, all I care about is the body inside of those clothes. My goal is to make your body so incredible that whether you wear an old t-shirt or a very expensive suit, you look dynamite. You look great. So going to the gym, that's the time of transformation. And as he said, the clothing should be loose, it should be comfortable, and it should support the gym activities that you want to perform. But ultimately, let's not lose sight of the big picture. We're here to transform you. We're not here just to exercise. We're here to use exercise as a tool to transform your body. So what, when someone sees you who knows you well, after seeing us for a little while, they will be shocked. They will say, "What happened? You look totally different. Last night I was reading a comic book, you look like someone in the comic book." That's what we want. Wear whatever you want, because the inside is gonna be pure Gold's Gym. When it comes to following a correct diet, I know that India is known for its exquisite cuisine. Food here is delicious and unusual. It's unusual in a way where I've traveled the world, some of the flavors and spices I've experienced here in India, they're incredible. I've never had them before. But let's not forget about the important art of transformation. Transformation requires three things and three things only. Proper exercise, based on your goals. Proper diet and proper sleep. No matter where you go all over the world, those three facts remain the same. If a normal person wants to transform into an extraordinary version of themselves, they have to follow the diet that will bring them to their goal. And that goal is different for different people. I meet women all the time that are normal and a little bit big, and they want to sleek out. They want to be elongated and slim. So they must follow a diet that promotes that in their body. Conversely, I sometimes meet men who are very nice and very, very strong, but little. They want to grow bigger and stronger, commanding like a hero. They must consume the right food to instruct their body to grow. It has nothing to do with tasting and cuisine, because around the world, it doesn't matter where you are, certain foods will help you grow. Certain foods will help bring you down. You don't have to deny yourself all of the pleasures of India's food, but you do have to recognize that during the time of transition, from the moment we start to the moment we reach our destination, you must follow the specific prescribed diet that comes from these trainers, because we're here to help you. We're not here to set up a diet that lasts forever where you have to eat boring food. We're here to give you a quick change, a transition from normal to extraordinary. And once again, as we established, once you achieve your goal of extraordinary, it's much easier to remain there. So perhaps during the time that you're going from normal to extraordinary, your diet will be a little more strict and you'll have to avoid some of your favorite Indian foods. But when you arrive at that destination, we can slowly but surely start adding in your favorite cuisine, and you will not go back to where you were. Because we're in charge of your good looks and good health, we would never let that happen. When it comes to deciding the correct exercises and the correct weights to use for different body parts, tricep, bicep, deltoid, pectoral, lats, whatever the body part, we select the weight and the exercise completely based upon your goal. Remember, goals are different for everyone. It's like going to a restaurant. If he and I went to a restaurant and we look at the menu, I might order something different than he orders, and that's okay. The best trainers in the world can deliver whatever result you want. And based upon only what you want, we decide which exercises to do and how to do them. For example, if he wanted to take his muscles, because look at this guy, he's got a lot of muscles, he looks great. If he hired me to change him, because maybe he got a role in a movie where he has to play a castaway, someone who was on a ship, and it got on an island, and there's no food, so his body would have to get smaller. There are movies that are made like that. If he was an actor that looked like this, and I had to make him smaller, would I use big heavy weights? No way, because that would make him only bigger. And I would have to change this body based on the role. So I would use a series of body weight functional exercises to challenge him at a high level of exertion, but specifically designed to make his muscles work to get smaller. I would change his diet to very lean protein sources, like egg whites and salmon and tuna. Very, very lean, that would promote muscularity that's small and elongated. I would have him drink lots of water and sleep, because sleep is the only time the body can change. All physical transformation occurs exclusively during sleep. So that would be a good example if we wanted to make him smaller. If he hired me to make him bigger, maybe he looks good already. Maybe we should get him ready for the Mr. Olympia Bodybuilding Championship in Las Vegas. No problem. I would call all my friends at the grocery store and they would deliver eggs, whole eggs to him that he would be eating. We would get some beef steak and he would eat that, and mutton. Mutton's fantastic for growing. And cheese. We would give him the right foods to grow and I would select the right weights. Heavy, heavy weights, basic movements, very heavy, low repetitions. So when you think about goals, you have to think about what exercise will make that goal happen. And it changes all the time, but the greatest trainer is almost like a black belt in martial arts. You no longer have to think, you know, so you can react and help people here, there, all over the place. I'll tell you one funny story about vegetarians. In my career as a personal trainer, and remember, I've been a personal trainer for a quarter of a century, 25 years. In my experience, I've only met a few vegetarians that are working out at high levels, trying to gain muscle mass, until I came to India. This is the land of vegetarians. Everywhere I go, I'm a vegetarian. If I sold meat here in India, I would be very poor. I would only sell vegetables because there are so many vegetarians here. If you're a vegetarian looking to gain muscle mass, it can be a real challenge for you, because muscle mass grows most effectively on a diet that includes animal-based protein. However, it still can be done. In America, vegetarians that work out use pea protein. You know peas, the little green vegetables? They use a special pea protein because peas are slow-burning carbohydrate and they contain microscopic bits of protein, and it's very effective. For those vegetarians out there that eat egg whites can still help you gain some nice muscle mass. If not, dairy can help you. So if you eat cheese, drink milk, have those types of things, whey protein, those are all excellent sources. But I can tell you, it's much more of a challenge to gain muscle mass as a vegetarian than if you were eating meat. One thing that's very interesting about India that I never expected, and that is, everybody seemed like they were in a rush. We started in Mumbai, and as we traveled through the city of Mumbai, on the way to the gym, everyone's racing around. Whether it's early in the morning or late at night, people are on the go. Then we went to Delhi, then we went to Bangalore, and I'll tell you, people in India in general are very, very busy. They work long hours, they stay out at night sometimes, woohoo, having a good time, and that's fine, but it's important to make time for the gym. Now, for those people in India that want to go to the gym but still find themselves in a rush, I have great news for you. My style of training that I use in Hollywood is quick results training. I'm a Hollywood physique expert, meaning everywhere else in the world, when a client comes in, a normal trainer sets up a relationship with that client, and they work with them for weeks and months, and sometimes even years, to achieve a desired result. I am not like that at all. In Hollywood, I'll be in my office, and I'll get a call from a movie studio. This actor is coming over to your gym right now. He's leaving for Toronto, Canada in 10 days to shoot a movie, and he needs to look like a soldier. Guess what I have to do? I have to get him ready in 10 days. I have to put him through a fast transformation. So if the people in India are busy, if they have a fast-paced life, but they still want to change, I'm the best friend they ever had. Our methods here at Gold's Gym will transform you quickly so you can enjoy and continue your busy lifestyle and still look and feel your best. Everywhere in the world, it's absolutely true that there are many different types of exercises you can do within the confines of a gym. You can go into a gym and you can do cardio to stimulate your breathing, to stimulate your blood flow and your heart going faster. You can go into a gym and you can lift weights, free weights, machines, bands, whatever you want to do. Or you can go into a gym, not touch any of the equipment, and do pull-ups and push-ups and just use your body weight. But as we discuss all of these exercises, think about them as exercises. I know how to exercise and I can exercise with people, but my specialty, my mission in life is physical transformation. I use exercise as a tool to transform the body. I don't exercise with clients. Exercising alone with clients is like being a cab driver where the client gets into your cab and you drive around. There is no destination. You're just driving around. Is he gonna be happy? Does he wanna sit in the back of a cab all day long, driving around in traffic? No, it's a waste of time. It leads to no destination. That's why we came up with a method of physical transformation using exercise as a tool. So, like a good cab driver, he gets into my cab, he says, take me to the hotel downtown. I can drive directly there. He says, take me to the airport. I'm gonna leave town. I can take him directly to the airport. It's much, much more efficient. It saves time, it saves a lot of money, and it fulfills the dreams and destiny of the client. That's my mission. My mission is to teach the Gold's Gym trainers exactly how to fulfill the dreams and destiny of their clients by using fitness as a tool to transform the body, not just exercise.
For any individual who just have a basic goal of becoming fit, not aiming to be on any particular bodybuilding stage or on screen, I would advise these people should be practicing different components of fitness. Like any individual should be able to run or climb a certain distance. He or she should be having a good muscular strength. They should be also flexible so their body moves accordingly, and they should be having a very good composition, that is a fat to muscle ratio. So I would advise individuals to segregate their workout into different styles. Maybe they can do 2 days of cardiovascular training, maybe running on treadmills or moving out on a jogging track. Then they can spend few hours in the gym training with the weights to tone up their muscles and to strengthen their core. I would advise also people to practice yoga as it focuses on the breathing and flexibility part. So combining all this stuff together will give you a better body composition.
Well, I obviously think that people should be fit and healthy. A normal person that comes to the gym should have some sort of weight training to make their muscles stronger, resistance training, some sort of cardiovascular stimulation, like running on a treadmill or riding a bicycle. I actually have many of my clients do a little bit of martial arts, because I think it's much more interesting and it teaches a skill, and it can be very, very practically good to know some basic self-defense technique. And of course, I always stress the importance of great diet and good sleep. Sleep is the most important. I have noticed many early mornings that I've been here in India that I see people going on long walks. And that's very, very good. It's a great healthy habit to take. It also allows you to clear your mind after sleeping and prepare yourself for the day. In Los Angeles, we call this moving meditation. You're allowing your mind to think, you're becoming one with nature, you're exercising your body, and you're beginning that circulation going that will set you up for success for the rest of the day. Coming to the gym and walking on the treadmill is almost the same thing. However, it takes you out of nature. And I'm a firm believer that being within the confines of nature is sometimes a very special thing. So if the weather is bad or you wake up late and you have to walk on the treadmill, that's okay. but I encourage you to get out and move your body every single day to look and feel your best.
The minimum time you spend in the gym is 20 minutes and you can extend it up to 45 to 60 minutes. So it should be a smart workout rather than hard workout. The intensity should be high rather than the volume becoming more. So I would not advise to work out more than 1.5 hours or spend time in the gym. It should be rather much quicker and you burn more calories within that time span. I would advise every individual to have a quick sessions of around 45 to 60 minutes. Basically a warm-up given to a client before they enter into the main workout zone, along with something that prepares your body to go into a main working out phase. So it improves the blood circulations, it improves the mobility within your joints so that it prevents you from going into any kind of injury. So I would advise before you start with your actual main workout, there has to be a very good warm-up session, so say around 15 minutes.
For many people living here in India, very much like the major cities in America, New York, Los Angeles, Chicago, Miami, your stress level due to work can be very, very high. If work is very stressful, and if home life is stressful, that can cause negative effects upon the body. It can cause premature balding, it can cause depression, it can actually cause aches and pains in the body due specifically to stress. The way to get around that is physical activity, good eating, and good sleep. The gym is a great way to make stress go away. And the interesting thing is, all of the large pharmaceutical companies have released antidepressants that sell very well worldwide, especially in America. But they've never been able to replicate the effects of exercise, because when you exercise correctly, the endorphins are released in your mind. It makes you feel less stress, happy, and it really solves the situation. So don't take a pill. Go meet this guy at Gold's Gym and he'll help you feel better.
I advise such clients to put their aggression, bring that aggression into the gym and hit the weights harder so that they get the special benefit of extra calorie loss. So taking that stress and sitting at home will make them look more fat and will change their mood in a negative way. So instead of that, you bring all that aggression into the gym and you hit some larger serious weights.
I'm a big fan of seeing women from India here in the gym, because I think that everyone, men and women, deserve the best good looks and good health they could ever imagine. For men and women, making sure that you have the right type of exercise for your goal, the right diet based on your goal, and adequate sleep will lead you to being beautiful and healthy. Most men and women, when they come to the gym, want the opposite result. Most men want to be bigger and stronger, and most women want to be sleek, feminine, and elongated. So it does make sense that men and women would work out at Gold's Gym doing different programs. However, the exercise, the diet, and the sleep remains the same for both genders, and I applaud all of the Indian women that come to the gym. Yesterday I taught a class, there were about 40 women. We were all working out at the same time. When we were finished with 45 minutes of working out, I've never seen so many smiles all together. It was very, very nice. I think women here in India need to be empowered to look their best and feel their best, and Gold's Gym is the best place to do that. We're very supportive of everyone. When it comes to exercise and self-defense, I have taught female self-defense in America for over 15 years. It's important for women to look their best and feel their best, but more importantly, to be empowered so if they're in a situation where they're nervous or frightened, they know how to take care of themselves. And I'll give you an example. Every 8 seconds somewhere in the world, a woman is attacked in a violent way. That's just a fact, that's just a statistic. Of those attacks every 8 seconds, usually the woman is pushed down from behind. These guys that attack women, they're cowards. They're not good, strong men. They're cowards, so they sneak up and they push a woman down. So if a woman here in India was attacked, most likely, statistically, she would be pushed from behind and she would find herself on all fours. That's the starting position all of the self-defense that we do. So if she's on all fours and she learns to lift her leg up to the side and kick, she will be exactly kicking at the level of the groin region of her attacker. It's perfect. But for women to practice self-defense standing up is not realistic, because bad guys are smart and they're cowards, so they'll push her down from behind. So we begin all of our female self-defense classes from an all fours position on the ground and teach them how to utilize the strength, the natural strength of a woman's lower body, which is usually quite high, to defend herself. And I'll be teaching those here too. And in conclusion, when it comes to being safe and confident as a woman here in India, my advice to you is to take the headphones off. Remember, this is the first time I've ever been to this country, and it's a beautiful, wonderful place with sights and sounds and smells that are different than anywhere else in the world. Many people in India, they sort of take that for granted. So instead of walking around listening to music or walking around listening to a phone call, take out your earphones, take out your Bluetooth, and be aware of your surroundings. It'll help you enjoy the country. It'll also help keep you very safe.
I completely agree with Mr. Eric, as he rightly said that you have to be alert, especially when you are moving on the roads. I have seen many females, or even males, they are getting lost with the headphones on their ears, listening to music or chatting on the phone calls, completely unaware about the situation, whether there's an attack, there could be an accidental case. So it is a right statement made by Mr. Eric that you have to be mentally and physically alert when you're on roads. Take care. Absolutely, for individuals above 50, gym is the priority, I would say, because that is the age when your muscles start deteriorating. Due to age, you end up losing muscles. You get naturally weak. So that is the right time when a gym plays an important role, where you work on the functionality. Any individual, if he or she at that particular age can get off from the chair without taking support, if he or she can climb up the staircase if the lift is not working, that is fitness for them. And to be fit, they have to train those muscles inside the gym. So I would advise special population above the age of 50 should visit gym very often.
You know, when you're younger, in your 20s, 30s, and 40s, and you go to the gym, sometimes it feels good to bulk up and put on some muscle mass. You look great, you feel great, you're strong, and people notice that you're feeling attractive, and it's very nice. But you know, after 40 or 50 years old, we focus on things that have to do with wellness. The shift changes from just good looks to good overall health. There's something called quality of life, meaning when you wake up in the morning at age 50, at age 60, at age 70, how do you feel? Do you feel strong? Do you feel happy? Do you feel aches? Or do you feel tired? Does your shoulder hurt? Does your knee hurt? We as trainers shift into a wellness mode with our clients around 45 years old, and we do different exercises and different stretches in a different level of intensity to promote wellness in their life. Their diet, their exercise, their sleep should all add up to a new equation of health and wellness. So they're injury free, so their circulation continues, so they're not stiff. You know, when you're very, very young, if I had a baby here, the baby would be very flexible. So we equate flexibility with youth. As you get older, if we had an old man in here, 80, 90, 100 years old, they're very stiff. So we equate being stiff with death. Therefore, if you take someone who's in their 40s or 50s, 60s, or even 70s, and you help them become more flexible with increased circulation, it can promote life to them, and it helps extend their life, and we call this wellness. Many times when you see Hollywood actors go through huge transformations, maybe one day they have to play a huge soldier fighting a war, and then the very next month they have to drop down play someone who's a prisoner of war. Maybe there's a lot of weight difference and a lot of muscular difference between those two parts. Normally, that kind of body transformation up and down, is very dangerous. It can be very hard on the heart, it can be very hard on the joints and the back, the kidneys, the liver. All of those things are affected as you stress them going up and going down. And you should never try to do this on your own. That's why the Hollywood superstars hire people like me, my friend here, to guide them through these transitions. And most people that we deal with, most people, they work in offices. They're lawyers, doctors, and professionals, and they will never be asked to be on that roller coaster of up and down, because it's really not great for you. But when it comes to Hollywood actors, through exercise, diet, and sleep, we safely bring them up, and we safely escort them back down to where they need to be. It's a special skill set that we have, and we'll share it with you.
As you rightly said, these drastic transformations could be bad to your heart, to your kidneys, to your liver, also to your joints. So I would advise that this transformation should be done under the guidance of right fitness professionals, taking the right guidance, and the person who has to undergo this transformation has to keep himself free, as Mr. Eric focuses on the three major principles to transformation, that is right exercise, right diet, and right sleep. So if you want to use this as a tool into your transformation, you have to be prepared mentally and physically for that.
I have a message for those young people here in India that are working at a Gold's Gym. You are very important to us. We care about your health, we care about your good looks, we care about the way that you feel, and we are dedicated and committed to helping you today and in the future. So my suggestion to you is go to the gym and talk to a personal trainer. They wear blue shirts, they wear red shirts, they wear all kinds of shirts, but they all say Gold's Gym on them. We're here to help you and help you attain your fitness goals with our expertise. Don't be shy and don't be practical. Many people have told you over the years, oh, in our family, we're naturally big. Oh, in our family, we're naturally lean, we can't gain muscle mass. Forget all of that. We have a special skill set that's beyond that which you have ever seen before, and we are dedicated to helping you achieve your fitness goals. It's gonna be fun. It's going to be a great trip that we'll take together, and we're only going to use three things. We're going to use proper exercise done safely with a healthy diet and some great sleep to make you into the person you always wanted to be. Thank you very much.
As I want to say that fitness is a journey and it's not a destination. So my first advice to all the youngsters or even the middle-aged people is to come out from their houses, come out from their chairs and beds and walk out towards the gym. Take a right professional's advice. We in Gold's Gym have a set of very good certified fitness professionals. So I would advise all the clients to take an advice from a certified professional. Carry a personal trainer along with you whenever you exercise, at least for 3 months, because that is the base. And if your base is right, then you can go very long.
Together we can and we will.